Hi, I'm Matt from Duo Security. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure the Duo Certificate Proxy to deploy certificates using Active Directory domain services and group policies. I will also show you how to configure a Trusted Endpoints policy to ensure that only corporate-owned devices managed by your organization are allowed to access your most sensitive browser applications that use the Duo prompt. Be sure to read the documentation for this trusted endpoint setup located at duo.com/docs/trusted-endpoints-adds before starting the installation process. In order to install the Duo Certificate Proxy for Active Directory, you will need to make sure you have the necessary prerequisites in place. You need an Active Directory domain account that is a member of both the Enterprise Admins and Domain Admins groups. You also need a Windows Server 2012 R2 machine joined to your Active Directory domain. We recommend that the Windows Server 2012 system have two 2 GHz processors, 8 GB of RAM, and 100 GB of disk space. In addition, you need a single network adapter with TCP/443 outbound internet access. Ensure that your server has all Windows updates, .NET Framework 4.5.2 or later, and the Windows 10 Universal C runtime installed. After making sure you have the necessary prerequisites, create the Active Directory Domain Services Management Integration in the Duo Admin panel. Open a browser and log in to the Duo Admin panel. In the left sidebar, click Trusted Endpoints Configuration. If this is your first Trusted Endpoints configuration, you will see an informational screen. Click Configure Management Tools Integration. Under Active Directory Domain Services, click Select this integration. Next, prepare your server for deployment of the certificate proxy. If your server is running a local firewall, you need to open TCP ports 135 and 1024 through 65535 for DCOM and RPC inbound access from your domain computers to the Duo Certificate Proxy. Log in to your Windows server. To permit access to these ports in the Windows Firewall, open Windows Firewall with Advanced Security. Right-click Inbound Rules and click New Rule. On the Rule Type page, select Custom. Click Next. On the Program page, set the rule to All Programs. Click Next. On the Protocol and Ports page, set the protocol type to TCP. In the dropdown for Local Port, select RPC Dynamic Ports. In the Remote Port dropdown, select Specific Ports. In the field below, enter 135, space 1024-65535. Click Next. On the scope page, leave both which local IP addresses does this rule apply to and which remote IP addresses does this rule apply to set to any IP address. Click Next. On the action page, select Allow the connection and click Next. On the profile page, select only the domain network option and then click Next. On the name page, enter a name to identify the rule, for example, Duo RPC/DCOM. Click Finish. Verify that your new Duo rule is enabled. After preparing your server, install and configure the certificate proxy. Log on to the server as a domain user who is a member of both the Domain Admins and Enterprise Admins groups. If you were added to either of those groups during your current logon session, then you need to log out and back in for your new privileges to take effect. Log in to the Duo Admin panel. Navigate to the Active Directory Domain Services integration page you created earlier. Click the link to download the Duo Certificate Proxy installer. Launch the installer and follow the prompts. leave the Launch Duo Certificate Proxy Wizard option checked on the final screen of the installer. Click Finish. The Duo Certificate Proxy Wizard will open. Click Next. The wizard will verify that you are an AD Enterprise and Domain Admin. Copy the secret key from your integration page and paste it in the wizard. Click Next. Specify the AD group or groups containing the users who will receive the Duo certificate. We recommend targeting a group of test users during initial configuration. You can return to the Duo Certificate Proxy Configuration Wizard later to add groups after verifying certificate enrollment and trusted endpoint reporting and access for a test group. Either click the Select button and type in all or part of an AD domain group, or type in the full name of the AD target group directly into the Configuration Wizard and click Validate to check the group name against AD. To specify more than one group, separate the group names with a comma. Do not input spaces before or after commas. Click Next. Pick the Trust Configuration method. If no public key infrastructure or PKI exists in your environment, such as Active Directory certificate services, select the first option. Install Duo Root Certificate as untrusted. If your organization does have an existing PKI, select the Trust the Duo Root option. Do not choose the Manual Setup of Duo Root option without first contacting Duo Support. For this example, we will select the first option. Click Next. Double-check your selected domain groups and trust configuration. If everything looks correct, click Confirm. Click Exit. You have completed the initial Duo Certificate Proxy configuration. Now configure your Group Policy Object, or GPO, for Duo Certificate deployment and browser configuration. On your domain controller or another system with the Windows Remote Server Administration tools installed, log in to the Duo Admin panel and navigate to your Active Directory Domain Services Management Tools integration. Then, launch the Group Policy Management Console, or GPMC. In the Group Policy Management Console, expand your forest and navigate down the tree to Group Policy Objects. Right-click the Group Policy Objects folder and click New. Enter a name for the new GPO like Duo Certificate Policy and click OK. Right-click the new GPO you created and click Edit. To enable automatic retrieval of the Duo Device Certificate by Domain Clients, navigate to User Configuration, Policies, Windows Settings, Security Settings, Public Key Policies. Double-click Certificate Services Client, Auto Enrollment in the right pane of the Policy Editor. On the Enrollment Policy Configuration Settings tab, set the configuration model to Enabled and check both the Renew Expired Certificates, Update Pending Certificates, and Remove Revoked Certificates, and Update Certificates that use Certificate Templates options. Then click OK. To enable automatic selection of the Duo Certificate by Internet Explorer on client endpoints, navigate to User Configuration, Preferences, Windows Settings, Registry. On the Duo Admin panel page for your ADDS Management Tools integration, click the Internet Explorer Configuration download link in the Configure Your Group Policy Object section of the page to obtain the Internet Explorer Configuration XML file. Save this file in a location accessible from the GPMC. Open that location in Windows Explorer. From the Explorer window, copy the downloaded Internet Explorer XML file, not the file contents, and paste it into the registry pane on the right side of the GPO editor window. When asked if you are sure you want to import the pasted document, click Yes. These registry values allow Internet Explorer to automatically select the Duo device certificate when requested by the Duo browser prompt. If you do not push these registry settings to your Windows clients, then Internet Explorer prompts users to manually select the Duo certificate during authentication. If Windows clients also use the Google Chrome browser when accessing Duo-protected applications, you should configure automatic certificate selection for Chrome in the GPO as well. Back in the Duo admin panel, click the Chrome Configuration Download link to obtain the Chrome Configuration XML file. Again, save this file in a location accessible from the GPMC. Then copy the Chrome XML file, not the file contents, from the Windows Explorer window and paste it into the top-level registry pane on the right of the GPO editor window. Confirm import of the pasted document by clicking Yes. This registry value lets Chrome automatically select the Duo device certificate when requested by the Duo browser prompt without prompting the user interactively to select the certificate. When you have finished configuring all settings, close the Group Policy Editor window. Now apply the Duo GPO. Click the Delegations tab of your new Duo Certificate GPO and then click the Advanced button in the lower right corner. On the Security tab, click the Add button. Enter Domain Computers in the Select Users, Computers, Service Accounts, or Groups dialog and click OK. In the Group or Usernames list, click on the Domain Computers group. In the Permissions for Domain Computers area in the bottom half of the Security Settings window, check the boxes for Read and Apply Group Policy in the Allow column. Click OK. The default GPO security filtering applies the new policy to all domain authenticated users. Restrict this new GPO so that it applies to only members of the domain group or groups you specified during Duo Certificate Proxy configuration. Click the Scope tab of the new Duo Certificate GPO. In the Security Filtering section, click Authenticated Users to select it and then click Remove. Next, click the Add button under Security Filtering. Select the same domain groups you selected on the Select AD Group page of the Duo Certificate Proxy Configuration Wizard and click OK. Those groups are added to the security filtering list alongside the Domain Computers group. Finally, link the policy. Right-click on your domain in the left side of the GPMC and select Link an Existing GPO. Select the New Duo Certificate GPO in the list of group policy objects and click OK. Confirm that the Duo Certificate Proxy is working by manually applying the Duo GPO settings on an endpoint. Log on to a domain-joined client PC as a member of the pilot group specified during the Duo Certificate Proxy group selection and in the Duo Certificate GPO scope. Open a browser and navigate to the documentation page located at duo.com/docs/trusted-endpoints-adds. In the left sidebar, click the anchor link to skip down to the Verify Your Setup section. There are commands in this section that you'll need to copy and paste into a command prompt. Open a command prompt window and run the gpupdate/force command provided in step 2 of this section of the documentation. After the policy update completes, run the gpresult/v command from step 3 of the documentation. In the output, under Applied Group Policy Objects, look for your new Duo GPO. If the Duo Certificate Enrollment GPO was successfully applied, check that the Duo Certificate was successfully obtained via the Duo Certificate Proxy server. In the same command prompt window where you ran gpresult, run the Certificate Manager tool using the command provided in step 4 of the documentation. Expand Certificates, Current User, Personal, Certificates. Look for the Duo Device Authentication Certificate in the list. Finally, verify the Chrome and Internet Explorer registry changes from the GPO. In your Command Prompt window, run the Registry Query commands provided in Step 6 of the documentation to check for the new Internet Explorer and Chrome settings. Confirm that the output of your query contains the two items highlighted in the screenshot in the documentation. You have successfully configured the Duo Certificate Proxy and deployment of the Duo Trusted Endpoints Certificate. Once your domain users' computers apply the new certificate GPO settings and receive the Duo Certificate, you can configure the Trusted Endpoints policy to start checking for the certificate as users authenticate to Duo protected services and applications. Please read the documentation located at duo.com/docs/trusted-endpoints before watching this section of the video. You will need to have a test group of users and select a browser-based application to use with your Trusted Endpoints policy. Log in to the Duo Admin panel as an administrator with the Owner or Administrator Admin role. Navigate to the Properties page for the application you want to use Trusted Endpoints with. Click the Apply a Policy to a Group of Users button, then click or Create a New Policy. The Policy Editor launches. Enter a name for the policy at the top of the left column, such as Trusted Endpoints. Then, in the left menu, under Devices, click Trusted Endpoints. Select the Radio button for Block Endpoints that do not have a Duo certificate. Click the Create Policy button to save your settings and return to the Apply a Policy prompt with your new policy selected. In the Groups field, select the group of users you want to apply the policy to. Click the Apply Policy button. You will see your applied policy on your Properties page. Now, when a user with an endpoint that lacks a Duo certificate attempts to access this application, they will not be allowed access. A prompt will appear indicating that they are being blocked due to their use of a personal device. You have successfully configured the Duo Certificate Proxy, deployment of the Duo Trusted Endpoints Certificate, and a Trusted Endpoints Policy.